down by the headquarters. This is Soren speaking. How may I help you?
I see. You've been turned into a frog. Now, was this done by a witch, a wizard, or a sorcerer?
A witch?
Okay, and your name is?
Eric. Now, Eric, what can we do for you today?
Send someone to turn you back into a person?
Well, isn't there a beautiful princess nearby who can kiss you? So you were really kind of busy today, and...
Okay, Eric, let me put you on for just 1 second. Hey, boss?
What is it, Hortense? Can you see I'm trying to get the decorations finished before the big party?
We got a call from your future king who's been turned into a frog.
Well, can you just find some beautiful princess to kiss them and turn them back? Why do we have to do everything?
Why would a beautiful princess kiss a slimy frog? That just doesn't make any sense.
Good point. I have done that. Okay, which fairy godmother should we?
We have Tinkerbell.
No! She's granted some wishes to a bunch of gnomes at 4:30. Who else you got?
We got Flora, Merryweather, and Fauna.
Well, then who'll be around to wake up Sleeping Beauty? Use your head!
Sorry, boss. Say Carmichael's free.
Good. Send her. We'll tell her to her out so she can get back in time for the party.
Okay, sir. We're sending you out a fairy godmother right away. Her name is Carmichael. She will be granting you 3 wishes today. You're very welcome now. Try not to get eaten before she arrives. Okay. Bye-bye now.
Now hear this. Will Carmichael please report to dispatch? Will Carmichael please report to dispatch?
Hey, guys. What's up? Where's Carmichael?
We're still here on the 567. Is that the potato salad?
Yep. I got 5 dances to make sure we had enough for everyone.
What deli did you go to?
Well, the deli was closed, so I got it from some guy in a stand over by the swamp. But he let me have it 50% off because it was the end of the day.
What time is the party starting? In about 5 minutes, we want to make sure we get dinner done. As soon as Cinderella calls her, as soon as you get back from helping her, we'll start the limb up contest. Now, are you sure you got everything ready?
Boss, we've been over this 500 times. I get her a new dress, I turn the pumpkin into a coach, I turn the mice into coachmen, and I give her the glass slippers.
What about the mini thing? You forgot the mini thing!
You didn't let me finish! I tell her it all wears off at midnight. By the way, boss, I've been meaning to ask, why does it have to wear off at midnight? Why can't I just make it last all night?
What? Not do the minute thing. If you don't do the minute thing, you lose that great dramatic tension in the story where she runs out of the palace as the bell rings midnight and the prince is chasing her and the dramatic music starts. Stop! In the name of love! If you don't do the minute thing, you might as well not tell the story. What's wrong with you?
Sheesh, boss. You need to calm down or you're going to have a stroke.
She's right, boss. You need to chill a little.
All right. It's just after the word how we help Cinderella gets out. Everyone's gonna want the fairy godmothers. This will make fairy godmothers famous for all time.
And to celebrate, we're gonna have the greatest party in history, both fairy godmother party!
Party! Woo! All right, settle down. We still have to hang the piñata and make the cheese dip. How long does Cinderella cost, bro?
About 3 hours.
All right, let's begin Operation Celebration.
Woo!
Laundry.
Well, what took so long?
Well, first I had to make the soap. Then I had to carry all the laundry down to the creek. That's 3 miles away. Then I had to beat all the clothes on the rocks in the freezing cold water. Then I had to wring all the clothes dry by twisting them around trees. Then I had to carry all the clothes 3 miles back home.
So, what took so long?
Yeah, it's not like this dream isn't downhill. Well, it's only downhill one way, evil stepsister Alberta.
What are you talking about? The stream is downhill.
Well, yes. When you're going to the stream, it's downhill. But when you're coming back, it's uphill.
Cinderella, do you think we're done? We both know the stream is downhill from here, and mountains can't move. We learned that in school.
And remember, we almost graduated the third grade, so don't think you can fool us. You're just trying to make excuses for being so slow and lazy.
Albert is right. Here you are complaining about a little laundry. What else have you had to do today?
Well, I got up at 4 in the morning and milked all of the cows. Then I made breakfast, chopped all the firewood for the week, took the milk to the market to sell, finished planting the cabbages, made your lunch, cleaned out the pigsty, then I did all the laundry.
That's all? Fabulosa, I thought you were gonna ever fix the roof.
Oh yeah, Cinderella, now that you have some free time, I need you to go and fix the roof.
But evil stepsister Fabulosa, we don't have a ladder tall enough to reach the roof. It's 30 feet high.
Oh gosh, Cinderella, that's just like you. Always trying to find excuses for getting out of doing work. There's that tall tree right next to the house. You can just climb up to the top of it and leap over onto the roof.
But if I fell, I could get really hurt.
And if the world was round, we'd all fall off. Stop complaining.
The world is round.
She thinks the world is round.
It's a good thing Mother never sent you to school, Cinderella. You would have flunked out of the third grade.
Cinderella, what are you doing sitting around here? You're supposed to be out building the new outhouse.
I just started digging the hole and my evil stepsisters called me in here.
Yes, I need Cinderella to cut my toenails. My big toenail is all green and my small toenail is all twisted and icky.
Before you do her toenails, I need you to rearrange my sock and underwear drawer. I want all the underwear moved from the third drawer to the top drawer and all the socks moved from the top drawer to the third drawer. I want it all sorted alphabetically and what color.
Don't be silly. Cinderella doesn't have time to waste on silly things like that.
Thank you, evil stepmother.
She has to go and build a new barn.
What new barn?
I ordered 100 llamas.
Llamas?
Llamas?
Llamas! 100 llamas? Who's going to take care of them? Think how much feeding and cleaning and work they're going to take. Who's going to do all of that?
You are.
But I don't have enough time to do all the chores I have now.
Get up earlier.
I get up at 4 in the morning.
Well then, go to bed later.
I go to bed at midnight.
Oh, stop being such a baby. Look, we're going to start raising llamas, we'll be able to rent them out to people, we'll be able to sell their fur, and we can use their milk to make llama cheese.
And we can eat them as well.
You don't eat llamas, silly goose. They're much too small. Why, they're barely big enough to fit into those little tubes and run around their little wheels.
Those are hamsters, Alberta. Llamas are the size of horses.
I know that. I don't need you to tell me that. I know all about llamas.
Llamas?
Oh, Giddy, then if they're that big, we can easily eat them.
We're not going to eat them. We're going to use them to make lots of money.
Money?
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 Oh, Mommy, when we get all of that money, can I buy lots of fabulous new clothes and jewelry and said they're very expensive and shiny?
Yes, you can, my little pumpkin.
And can I get an Xbox 360?
But those won't be invented for another 500 years.
Then can I get some sticks to play with?
Sure.
Yes, I'm gonna play with sticks.
Nasty stepmother, may I please buy some shoes? The rocks hurt my feet.
Cinderella, what are you still doing here? You're supposed to be out building the barn. Cinderella, go get the door.
I do it, but I don't want to.
Greetings and salutations, my good citizens. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Their Majesty's most royal messenger, Sir Walter Vaughn, UPS. I bid thee a most gracious and royal good day. I pray that you are in good health and fair spirits on this fine morn.
Say what?
Did you come to deliver the llamas?
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 Llamas!
Alas and alack, my dear lady. I'm afraid I come bearing no llamas to his most pleasant abode. No, I come bearing the most important and, dare I say, exciting message from her most royal majesty's King Vladimir, Queen Shania.
Well, what is it?
What is what, charming lady?
What's the message from the king and queen?
Ah, yes, yes, of course, the message. Oh, please forgive me, in all this excitement and joy, I forgot to deliver the message, which of course is the entire purpose of my journey to your place of residence, as it were. Please allow me to extend my most humble apologies, and please forgive me for my most inexcusable blunder. I'm afraid it is too much to ask.
Good, sir UPS. Kings think nothing of it.
Dear lady, you are too kind. How could I ever repay you for such kind mercy and your most gracious...
What's the message?!
Yes, the message. Right. Their most royal majesties, King Vladimir and Queen Shania, command your appearance at the royal ball to be held tonight at the palace. At this ball, his most royal majesty, Prince Charmful, heir to the royal throne, was elected as a bride, will become princess of the realm, and our next queen appetizers will be served.
Mommy, did you hear that? I think it's me, Prince Charmful, become the queen! Did you hear that? I make you the mother of the next queen! Did you hear that? They're serving appetizers!
Wait a minute. Did you say the ball was tonight? Why, that's no time at all to prepare! Why such late notice?
Look, lady, I've had to deliver one of these to every house in the whole stinking country. I've been walking around for 6 weeks. Can you cut me some slack?
Almost double, messenger. We thank you for your good and loyal service and this most wondrous news you've brought to our house.
Yeah. Now, Scram, we've got to get ready for the ball.
Hey, wait a minute. I just thought of something. If this Prince Charmful is such a catch, why do they have to hold a ball to get him a wife? Why can't he find his own wife? What's wrong with him, huh?
Oh, Fabulosa, don't be silly. Why, Prince Charmful is the most wonderful man in the whole world. Why, he's wise and brave and strong and smart and fearless, and any girl in the world would be lucky to marry him.
Well, he is a nice guy now, but to be perfectly honest, he is kind of quiet and shy and nerdy. And instead of fighting dragons or rescuing maidens, he likes to play with normal trains all day, which is kind of weird.
But trains won't be invented for another 400 years.
Yeah, that's why it's so weird. Well, anyways, none of the princesses in the surrounding kingdoms wanted to marry him, so his parents thought they'd throw this big giant dance party thing and marry him up before he got any weirder.
I don't care how odd he is, he's still a prince, and that means after I marry him, I get to become the queen and live in the castle.
Well, fair ladies, I wish you much delight and success in your endeavors, and a fine evening. I still have 52 messages to deliver in only 45 minutes, and since I'm considered management, there should be no overtime for me.
Can you believe it? We get to go to a ball at the palace, and I will get the prince to fall in love with me and marry me, and I will rule over the whole country.
And I will get the prince to help fall in love with you, and I shall be the mother of the next queen, and I shall tell you how to rule the whole country.
I wonder if those are pigs in a blanket. Those are some good eating.
I think I'll wear the new dress I sewed out of hay. It's a little itchy, but I won't mind if I get to see the palace and meet the prince. What are you laughing about?
Cinderella. You're most certainly not going to the ball.
Yeah, you're kind of smelly from being in the barn and other stuff.
I can take a bath.
But then there might not be enough hot water for me. Besides, I can't be seen attending the ball with someone who's wearing a hay dress.
I could borrow one of your dresses.
No.
Oh, wicked stepmother, why can't I go to the ball?
Cinderella, if you were to go to the ball, who wouldn't be here in case they deliver the llamas?
All right, Fabulous and Alberta, if we're going to the ball, we need to shave our backs.
Oh, why can't I go to the ball? It's not fair. All I want to do is wear a beautiful dress and beautiful shoes and ride in a beautiful carriage to the beautiful palace and have a beautiful dance with a beautiful prince. Is that too much to ask? Oh, if there was only someone out there who can hear my dreams, someone who can
that again. Sorry about the food poisoning, boss. But on the bright side, we didn't have to pay all the money for potato salad.
What's that?
Oh no, it's Cinderella. She's asking for help.
Quick, Sparta, get down these stairs, Cinderella, and make us all proud of you.
Right, boss. I'm just going.
It's not gonna look good. If the fairy godmother and Cinderella's running out to throw up every 5 minutes.
I know that. We just send someone else.
But boss, there isn't anyone else. Every mouse is sicker than Esperanto. If we don't help Cinderella tonight, she'll never marry the prince and we'll never live happily ever after. No one will ever call fairy godmothers for help ever again. Oh, woe is us.
Don't you spur Hortense. After Emery said she gets sick, I took a precaution in calling me sub.
A what?
A substitute fairy godmother. I got off the sub list.
But boss, this is Cinderella, the most important fairy godmother in history. You can't send a substitute fairy godmother.
We don't have a choice. It's either send a sub or abandon Cinderella and cruel fates. We can only hope the substitute fairy godmother is a good one.
Hello! Oh my goodness gracious, that's smart, Violet.
own mysterious one?
My name is Lucretia Fosfor. I'm pleased to meet you. Would you be interested in purchasing some Santa candles?
I beg your pardon?
Would you be interested in purchasing some Santa candles? Oh my goodness, I have been home to get Santa candles. Now please don't take this personally, because I'm sure you must work hard every day around animals to get all sweaty. But this room could do a lot of freshening up. Now to cover a strong stench like this, I usually recommend a French vanilla. Unfortunately, that has a tendency to fall and burn people's houses down. So maybe you should go with the cinnamon.
Okay, what's going on here? Aren't you supposed to be my fairy godmother?
Oh my goodness gracious, I completely forgot. You see, I get so mixed up with all that whizzing thriller and the big toothing stuff, and I don't know where my mind goes sometimes.
So you are my fairy godmother?
Yes, indeed. Well, I'm the stuffed fairy godmother. You see, the scheduled fairy godmother got food poisoning today, so they called me in. You just gotta be so very careful of potato salad in the heat, or really any food with mayonnaise in it. Now, my mother used to make potato salad with no mayonnaise in it at all. She used Crisco instead. Of course, it didn't taste very well, so no one would ever eat it. But my mother always said, better safe than...
Look, I don't mean to be rude, but the ball started 2 hours ago. And if I don't get there anytime soon, the prince will already be married and on his way to the honeymoon. So if you just hurry up a little, that would be great.
Of course, they did tell me it was dumb. Now let's see here. You want to be a boy?
What? I don't want to be a boy. I want to go to the ball.
Oh dear, that was my last job. Now let's see here. Cinderella. Got it. Of course you won't be a boy.
I bet you don't be a yak either.
What?
Okay, now first on the list is a coach made out of pumpkin. That's sort of difficult. Rapidly Brewski? No, that isn't it. Ricky Rackety? No, that isn't it either. Why don't we save that one for later? Okay, now next on the list are three mice turned into coachmen. That's much easier. Now where do you keep your mice, dear?
I don't keep any mice. The only mice we have here are in the walls.
Splendid. Prepare to be amazed. Ricky Racky Racky Ricky Sis Boom!
Difficult and I haven't done it in a long time.
But here it goes. Ickity spickity speck speck sis boom boom! Ah! Oh dear, that doesn't sound good.
I say, I don't mean to interrupt. Oh, I say, that was rather shocking. What? How do? My name is Murren. Murren the Big Bravo. And who's that person you're speaking to?
Are you kidding me? Is that supposed to be my beautiful gal?
Well,
it's ugly. And two, it's on a wolf.
Well, I did get part of it right. You see, in the manual, the spell for beautiful gowns is right next to the spell for ugly gowns and animal transportation.
I say, I don't mean to interrupt, but if we're going to be too much of a bother, could you please possibly tell me where I am and why I'm wearing this dress?
Well, that's Cinderella, and I'm her fairy godmother.
Substitute.
So I'm her substitute fairy godmother. We were trying to get her gown for the dress. For the ball, and as soon as you came along with it.
But everyone go, what? As for myself, I was in the process of shopping for my dinner where I found myself here. Charlie Peculiar, what?
Look at the time. If I'm not out of here in 5 minutes, I might as well go out and build the llama barn. Hey, Wolf, get out of my dress now.
Good zooks, my dear lady. If I were to take off this dress, ugly as it is, I'll be totally naked.
Well, you're a wolf. You're always naked.
Oh, quite right. But then, of course, we have this dress. It's rather ugly anyway. Let me just.
Hey, lady, we finished all your dip and Marie fit all your pickles.
Hey, it's the wolf!
The pigs!
Stop it! What are you doing?
He's trying to eat us!
I'm merely attempting to secure myself. I see nothing wrong whatsoever in that. How'd you like if we tried to eat you, bro? That would be a very bad form, old chap.
Oh, I'll laugh. Knock it off! Listen up and listen up good. Tonight is the most important night of my life, and I'm not gonna let a bunch of pigs, a wolf, or a nutcase ruin it for me.
Isn't that true?
You! Now get this straight! No one is eating anyone in this house. You, take off my dress, now! And you, give me my glass slippers.
Glass slippers?
Don't tell me you haven't got my glass slippers!
You see, I actually haven't worn this cloth for this. I could possibly try to create some patented leather clogs.
I say, glass slippers sound very dangerous to me.
Yeah, what if you stuck your toe? You can't use your jaw.
Or supposed to get real ugly feet and everyone can see them.
Yeah. Plus, wouldn't you need glass clogs for glass slippers?
Fine, forget about the glass slippers. Just give me your shoes.
But
listen, I'm not going to the ball barefoot. Now give me your shoes.
Very well.
What?
And he can't dance if his life depended on it. And he doesn't talk to people, and he gets sick of putting it. Besides that, it's a great idea.
Well, I'm glad you agree. Of course, if you didn't, that would be treason, and I would have to have you arrested.
Then I would have to have you arrested for arresting the queen, because that would be treason as well. Then we'd both be in the dungeon, and there would be no one left to run this country except for Chonful.
Oh, well, we wouldn't want that, now, would we? All right, I won't ever arrest you, my little pork chop.
Oh, thank you, Lambie Pie. Oh, look, here comes Chonful now.
Look, Mommy and Daddy, I just finished my new model train. Isn't it keen?
Son, you're 27 years old and gonna be king of the country one day. Don't you think it's time you stop using words like keen?
I'm afraid your father's right. It's not very kingly.
How about nifty, swell, the cat pajamas?
Look, I give up. Let's just have another child.
Not unless you plan on having this kid this time. 32 hours later was enough for me. Besides, Chonful will do just fine. Honey, will you be bringing your toys to the ball?
Mother, I've told you 100 times they're not toys. They're scale models based on the actual design of the train. Whenever they're actually invented. And no, I will not be taken to the ball because I will not be going to the ball. I don't want a wife. What do you say to a wife? It's just too much. I'm not going.
Look, you're going to the ball or else.
Or else for what?
Me and your father discussed this. Well, your father screamed and yelled while I discussed. And then he agreed with me. If you don't find a wife tonight, we're selling all your trains on eBay.
What? You wouldn't dare!
Oh, yes, we would. So it's your choice. Model trains or a wife? What's it gonna be?
Why'd I have to be born a prince? Why can't I be born a llama farmer?
You're not a llama farmer, you're a prince. And why would anybody be dumb enough to raise llamas?
Well, you can sell their fur and make llama cheese.
Enough! Are you going to the ball or not?
Fine, I'll go and get married, but I'm not going to like it.
Why should you just be different from anyone else?
What was that?
What I meant was, what I said was, I'm a very stupid man.
That's right. Very well, let the ball begin.
Welcome all to this very special ball. We are gathered here to choose a bride for our son. Prince Chonful, heir to the throne.
Now the prince would like to welcome you all.
What?
Go on, son, and speak up.
Give me this.
I said, I don't really want to do this. I hate dancing. Hate dances, and I'd much rather be working on my new model train than be at this dumb ball. And it's really big, has six wheels, and real smoke comes out of the smokestack. And it's much better than anywhere. So, welcome.
Party started. me, nae-nae.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me, nae-nae.
My son, Prince Charmful.
Oh, your princess, I've just been dying to meet, but I get a chance to talk to you. And I just know we're gonna fall in love tonight and get married, because my psychic told me so. She also said we're gonna have two babies.
What?
I think we should name them Alice, Susan, Peter, Koopa, Brick, Mildred, Tommy, Marco, and Cinnamon Jr. Also, I like to go to you. The castle's nice and all, but it's all cold and damp, made of stone and rock, and the mother's slipping.
That's to keep the bad guys out.
You are so cute. Anyway, I'd like to build the new castle. With shrubs and bushes and whatnot. And, I was thinking about it, and I don't really like the title of queen very much, because the queen is always weaker than the king, and I don't really think that's the basis of a healthy relationship, so I was thinking when you become king, I'd be called Pope. Either that, or you become Pope.
What?
Is there something wrong, Cookie?
Would you like to go see the moat? It's really beautiful at this time of night. You can't see all the ghosts floating in.
Well, we certainly gonna have to get rid of any moats. It's just a danger. The town of kids running around.
Exactly what I was thinking. Maybe we can take the moat out and replace it with some curtains or something? Say, why don't you go down there and start measuring for the curtains? I'll be right along. Guess I should have told her it's really slippery around the moat. Oh well. Say, aren't you going to dance?
I don't want to dance with you.
But you see, you have to dance with me so I can decide if I want to marry you or not.
I don't want to marry you.
Oh good, I don't want to marry you either. That is, I don't want to marry anyone, but if you don't want to marry me, why'd you come to the ball?
My parents made me come. They want me to marry a prince, but I want to marry Oscar.
Who's Oscar?
Oscar is the name of my boyfriend. He's the village podiatrist, and he's the most wonderful man in the world. He's smart and good-looking and brave. He's nothing like you at all, and I love him, and I want to marry him. My parents won't let me.
Why not?
They say he doesn't have enough money. But it's not his fault. People in fairy tales don't usually pay attention to proper foot care. Oh, Oscar, I love you so.
How much money do you want your parents want Oscar to have?
At least $25. Oh, Oscar, my heart is breaking for your love.
$25? Is that all?
Where's Oscar going to get that kind of money? He isn't a very good podiatrist.
Look, if I give you the money, will you go away?
Would you do that?
Here, take these 12 gold pieces and fly to your lover's arms.
12 gold pieces? Is that the same as 25 bucks?
Look, lady, go.
No, Oscar, my honey bunny of loveliness, I'm coming to you.
Okay, you can go now.
Oh, Oscar, my little Oscar, Oscar, I love you.
Security!
Thank you.
I'm so pleased to meet you.
Likewise, I'm sure.
It must be so wonderful living here in the palace with all the silk tapestry and gold and artworks and storerooms full of gold.
My room gets a little drafty during the winter, but that's because I live up in the tower.
Oh, Your Majesty, you're so funny. No wonder all the ladies here want to marry you.
I think that's mostly because I'm rich and because I'm going to be king someday.
Really? I guess I hadn't thought about that. My, but you're a lovely dancer.
Really? That's funny. I keep stepping on everyone's feet, and I'm tone deaf and very good coordinated. And all the other girls kept making faces and crying.
Take my word for it, Your Majesty. You're an amazing dancer.
Gosh, that's nice thing to say. Hey, I'm supposed to get married tonight. Would you like to be my...
Right. Where's the prince?
Who are you?
I'm a fair maiden, and I got invited to the ball, and I'm gonna dance with the prince, and nobody better try and stop me because I had a really, really lousy night. Look out, honey. I'm cutting in.
I don't know. Annoying Prince Charmful? That's exactly the kind of woman he would marry.
But I can see what that girl did to me. I did. But have no fears, my dear.
There is no way she can compete with your beauty, charm, and grace.
But I wonder, who could that mysterious stranger be?
Are you kidding me? That's Cinderella! She's just wearing a really ugly dress and some funny looking shoes, but other than that, she looks the same! What, are you going blind?
Why, I'll go tear away from it right now!
No, don't do that! It'll look bad and cause a scene. Let Cinderella have her dance. And when she's done with it, I'll make sure she gets in trouble once and for all. What are you doing?
I was doing my evil laugh. Because you're going to do something bad to Cinderella when she gets home.
Oh, for heaven's sake. I'm only going to ground her. Now go get some pigs in a blanket.
Oh, Mommy, she's still dancing with them. How much longer is she going to hog him?
The dance is almost over at midnight, actually. Then you'll have the prince. Now, let's go get some pigs in a blanket.
Hey, are you all right? You seem frazzled.
You can say that again. This was supposed to be the best night of my life. Now, it's just a disaster. All I want to do is have my stupid dance and go home.
I'm sorry. My name is Prince Charmful, and I'm the prince.
I know!
Oh, please don't cry. There. You're at the ball, wearing a beautiful dress. It's not beautiful, but it's a dress. But your shoes are... Well, there's shoes. Your perfume smells like... Perfume smells like cows.
Wait till I have to take care of 100 llamas a day. Then I'll really smell good.
Llamas? Did you say llamas?
Yeah, starting tomorrow, besides all my other miserable chores. I'll have to take care of 100 llamas. That is, after I build our barn when I get home.
You mean you're gonna build a barn all by yourself?
Sure. I build everything around the house and milk the cows and make the cheese and...
Llama cheese? You make llama cheese?
Yeah, why? Do you like llama cheese?
Oh, well, I'm in my workshop and I'm working on my new model trains. There's nothing like better than a big slab of llama cheese.
Well, I'll be up to my armpits in llama cheese, so I'll send you over a couple pounds.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
Say, did you say you built models?
Yeah, I love to build things, don't you?
Yeah, building things is cool. Of course, all the things I build are huge, heavy structures because the rest of my family is too lazy to help out. But it is nice to look at something you've made with your own hands.
Say, do you have problems with your family as well?
You can say that. What's wrong with your family?
Well, they like nothing I do and they're always criticizing me.
Welcome to the club.
What club? Anyways, I don't know your name yet.
Well, it's... Oh, for the love of Mike, I gotta go now. Hey, thanks for the dance. It was fun, except for the part where you stepped on my feet.
I don't know who you are.
What in the world are you yelling about?
That girl that just left there, that's the girl I want to marry.
That's wonderful. What's your name?
I don't know.
Well, where does she live?
Can't say.
Where does she work?
I don't know.
Did she leave any clues as to her identity?
No.
Good work, son.
Don't listen to your father. You just have to search the whole kingdom for her. That'll only take 3 or 4 years. Honey, I think there's no blanket left.
Oh, scrumptious.
Don't worry, my darling. I'll find you no matter how far I should travel. Oh, you know, if it's not too far.
Cinderella, what is-
about, but I can tell you this. From now on, you'll be living in the llama barn. As soon as you build it.
Not so fast.
No one would dare harm my hair on my head of princess bride to be.
But, Your Majesty, how did you find me? I didn't leave a shoe.
A shoe? How would a shoe help me find you? Unless you write your name in it, but that would be a really strange thing to do.
Then how did you find me?
I asked the taxi cab company where you live. Now, if you wouldn't mind, will you come back to the palace and marry me? And we can work on my new model train together?
Oh, Prince Charles, nothing would make me happier.
All right, now that we're going to be married, you don't have to call me Prince Charles anymore. You can call me Prince.
Looks like I'm off to be rich and famous. See you losers later. Come on, Sugar Plum, let's get out.
Cinderella, what are we going to do with all these people?
Don't know, don't care.
One more thing. You three are to deliver 50 pounds of llama cheese to the palace every day, or else I'll have your heads cut off and throw you into the dungeon. That'll teach you two people.
Toodles.
Well, that's just ducky. I can't spend all day making llama cheese. I'll get all stinky and cheesy.
Now we don't have anyone to do our chores for us.
Hey, lady, you need to run to the store and get us some breakfast. We finished all your food.
I just think with the flower pot, honey, soy milk, or
my ears, yes, and pray to the word shall be sleeping tonight. I would rather send to the bag and require a firm mattress.
I smell really loud, so you might want to get me a real far away from her, but yes.
What are you guys talking about? You guys are not sleeping here!
Well, until that substitute fairy godmother lady figures out how to send us back to where we came from, we're staying right here!
Absolutely not! We refuse!
Well, seeing as I'm a wolf, I guess I should have to teach you then. What? Jolly good. Run!
Right, you can stay! Look, fairy godmother person lady, haven't you figured out how to fix all this?
Actually, I believe I have. But before I send you all your way, I can put out one thing. I did get to know them with Mary Prince, and they will have helped me the other after. So there. And so now, I bid you all farewell. Ricky,